Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollotech, and yesterday Apple released macOS Ventura 13 Beta 4. Also today they released macOS Ventura 13 Public Beta 2, so both of those are available now if you're a beta tester or developer. This came in at 1.98 gigabytes on my MacBook Pro and was about the same on all the devices I checked. Now along with this, Apple also released iOS 16 Beta 4, iPadOS 16 Beta 4, and both of those public betas released today as well. tvOS 16 Beta 4 and HomePodOS 16 Beta 4. So far, there's no watchOS 9 Beta 4, so we're still waiting for that, but there is a simulator in Xcode 14 Beta 4, so it's a bit surprising that the watch beta is not out. Now let's go ahead and close this. We'll talk about the build number and then check out what's new. So we'll go to About This Mac, click on the Ventura 13 here, as you can see. There we go, and it says 22A5311F. This is the current build number of this update, so that just lets you know which version you're on. Now, as far as what's new, let's take a look at messages first. So we'll go into messages, and within messages, if I type this is a test message, and then hit return or enter, you can see it's there immediately. Now I can undo send just like I could before, but the limit is now restricted to 2 minutes instead of 15. Also, if I want to edit this, maybe say this is a test message for macOS Ventura Beta 4. Now it's edited. It tells me it's edited. And if I click on it, we can see a change log from when it was edited before and what it is now. So this is actually visible to both the sender and recipient. So this is something some people don't like, but they've actually changed. It's a little change, but nothing huge, but something that is just there to kind of keep accountability as to what you said. Now, if we go into mail, within mail, if we go under mail and then settings, in our settings, if we click on composing, just like on iOS 16 beta 4, we can now change the undo send delay. With the mail app, we can now undo sent messages, and now we can change it to 10, 20, or 30 seconds, or turn it off completely. So that's a little bit different. The option was not there in beta 3. Now, if we go into Stage Manager, click on Stage Manager. The first time you open it, it will now say Stage Manager arranges your recent windows into a single strip for reduced clutter and quick access. Focus on one window at a time and create sets by mixing different apps to suit your workflow. If we click on Maybe Later, this will pop up next time. If we click Enable, it enables Stage Manager in this update. They've also updated Continuity Camera. So if we open FaceTime, my iPhone connects immediately. If we go up to our settings here, click on settings, we have our different effects, center stage, and so on. And if we click on desk view, there's some new information. So click on desk view, give it a second. Now it's telling us how to align everything. Use the plus minus controls to align your desk to the edge of the box. Click start desk view when ready. So align the desk to the edge of the box. You'll see there we can align it. That's sort of my desk. We'll click start desk view. And now you can see my keyboard. Of course, we can zoom out a little bit more if we want to, and you'll see my desk. So it's straightening everything with the Neural Engine, and there's just a little tutorial on how to use this a little bit better. So that's really nice that they've updated it and given us a little more information. I'm always amazed at how quickly this connects and how well it works. Now, if we go into the Home app, they've updated that as well. So we'll go into Home. This is my office currently. And in the upper right, we now have settings where we didn't before. On my other Mac, I don't have any settings. So now we have Home settings, Reorder sections, Home office, and we can switch. So if I go to Home settings and then we scroll down, just like on iOS, we now have two new wallpaper for this as well. So we have this sort of flower wallpaper for the background, or sort of an architectural corner as well, and then some additional gradients. So that's been updated in this version as well as on iOS. Within settings, there's a bunch of changes as well. I'll show you beta 3 on the left so you can compare. And as you can see on the right is beta 4. And if we go under privacy and security, and then we go down to all the way down here to security, you'll see it says allow apps downloaded from the app store and identified developer. So now these are buttons instead of dropdowns. And then also we now have our extension information here saying your current security settings prevent the installation of system extensions. We can enable this where it wasn't showing in beta 3. If we go into screen time, it's a little bit different. The switch to turn on screen time, turn it on or off, is at the top now instead of the bottom. So just a small change there. Then if we go under general and then we go to maybe our applications, we'll give it just a moment here to finish loading. We click the I, and now you can see the delete button is no longer red. This is a very minor change, but something that's a little bit different. If we click on something to remove, it's just typical black over white, where before it was red over white. Small change, but something different. Also within settings, if you go into Game Center for the first time, you'll have a new splash screen. I wasn't able to duplicate this again, and it actually was a little bit buggy, but you can see it says, what's new in Game Center? Of course, see all your friends' play activity and achievements. We had a new splash screen on iOS as well. Now there's a ton of bug fixes in this update also. And if we go into Safari and take a look at the notes, thankfully Apple publishes these to everyone now, and I'll leave a link to them in the description, but you can see over 45 different resolved issues. So the first one here is for Calendar, where it says the Enable This Account checkbox found in Calendar Preferences and Accounts won't function for certain account types, such as iCloud or Google, and this has been resolved. Same is true with the clock, where in the clock app, you might not be able to type a digit into the timer, hour, minute, or second fields. Also, if we continue down, you'll see things such as kernel management. In Mail, they've fixed a bunch of things. MapKit, Metal, as well as Metal Offline Compiler. Networking, they've deprecated some things here, or one thing. Safari, they've resolved some issues where reordering a shared tab group by one user reorders that tab group for every user in the share. Now it doesn't do that anymore. So on and on, there's a bunch of resolved issues. So a ton, just like iOS, where iOS had over 100, we have over 45 here. There's still known issues in this update as well, such as Stage Manager, as you can see here, where it says with Stage Manager active, windows continue as the key window and receive key events when minimized. So there's still known issues and there's no workaround for this. So just be aware that there still could be some bugs from time to time. And that leads me to, should you install this update? Well, of course, if you're on beta 3 or public beta 1, absolutely install it and be sure to provide feedback in the feedback app. However, if you're not on the betas yet and you're using a computer for production or anything else, I would hold off until a final release. Now, as far as when to expect the next beta, usually by the time we're at beta 4, we're on a weekly cycle, meaning that we should have one every single week until the final release. That's typically what Apple does, but they can change this up from year to year. So this week we got beta 4 and public beta 2. Next week we could have beta 5 and so on all the way until September until we have a final release, sometime in late September or early October, depending on the year, along with iOS updates as well. So beta 5 potentially next week. If not next week, it will be the following week. Apple has been a little bit different this year than they have been in the past. But either way, I would expect that. And we could even get a new macOS Monterey update in between, maybe a 12.6 or 12.5.1 or something along those lines. So look forward to those. Of course, if those release, they'll probably be just security updates and bug fixes. Now, if you found anything else in macOS Ventura Beta 4 or Public Beta 2, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And also let me know what Mac you're using. I'd love to hear from you there. I'll link this wallpaper in the description. This is a new wallpaper from Apple CarPlay wallpapers that's on beta 4 of iOS 16. I'll link this in the description if you want to check it out yourself. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.